In this video, we're going to try to answer the question of, do I need a WordPress theme? And the answer might surprise you. Hi, my name is Adam from WPCrafter.com, where I make WordPress tutorial videos for non-techies. If you're new here, consider clicking on the subscribe button, or if you want video notifications, click on that little bell and YouTube will let you know when I have a new video. So this question is coming up a lot, and this is actually more a video to open up the discussion of, do you need a WordPress theme? Now with products like Elementor Pro version 2, which is due to come out April 9th or so, it's currently in beta, what you now have is page builders that will create headers with the menu navigation, the logo. They'll create the whole headers for you, and the footers and the blog post styles, all of these things that traditionally were built using your WordPress theme and styled with your WordPress theme. Now you have page builders doing this. In fact, there's been another page builder that started doing that about a year ago. So the question is actually very relevant right now of, do you need a WordPress theme? In fact, if we look over here at Elementor's GitHub page. So this is a repository where developers will put all of their code. All of a sudden, there's this new entry called Elementor Hello Theme. And what this is it's a totally stripped down WordPress theme that you can use Elementor with, but then you would just be reliant upon Elementor for everything, and it just takes everything out that you might need a theme for. As a matter of fact, let's just go ahead and jump in here and take a look at what it's like using this Elementor Hello theme. So what you could do is, I'll put a link in the video description box to this. You just come to this page, click right here where it says clone or download, and then the drop down there, there's this option to download the zip, and then you can just upload that to your WordPress's themes section. So I've already done that right here. So if I go to appearance and then themes, you'll see I have it right there. And this is just a fresh installation of WordPress. And then here it is, the Elementor Hello theme. And this is what it looks like right now, as a matter of fact. There's absolutely nothing there. I think this might be a stripped down version of GeneratePress. If I was to look at the code, I might be able to confirm that. But there were some clues as to why I think that. So we could use this, and I already have Elementor Pro version 2, and we can convert it from this into a full website. This is how easy it would be to do that. You would go to Elementor, we can choose on My Templates, we can go to Add New, we'll select a header just like this, and I'll give it the name header. Okay, now I'm gonna click on Create Template. It'll just take a moment. It's gonna create that. I'll go ahead and choose this default one. Now these headers and footers and blog post styles and all that, it's a feature in Elementor Pro version 2. It's not in the normal free version of Elementor. When you click on Publish, we're going to choose Display Conditions, and I'm going to choose for this header to show on the entire website. I'll click on Publish. I'll click right here, and I'm going to go ahead and get out of this header that we put together. Now, if I click on Refresh, you see we have that header. Now, on the right, there'll be a menu navigation. I just haven't created a menu in this site. And then the next step, actually, we could just, let's see, we'll go here, let's assign a home page, and then we'll slap a template in there real quick. So I'm gonna click on Add New, I'll name it Home, just like that. I'll click on Publish, and then I'm gonna go ahead and click on Edit with Elementor, and we're just gonna use one of the Elementor templates. I'll click on Add Template, and we can really choose anything at this point. I'll just click on Insert right here. It's gonna go ahead and download everything, package it all up, and insert it in right here. Okay, so now I'm gonna go ahead and click on Update. Ah, we might be finding some problems already. See, I haven't tested this in advance. I'm gonna go back to the dashboard, but let's see if I go to templates, and here it is, Elementor Full Width. This is actually a new feature in Elementor version 2, is this template that says Elementor Full Width, and that should probably, let's take a look at this before we apply it. That should get rid of this. Let's see if that's what it does. So I'm gonna go back here, change this to Elementor Full Width, click on Update. We'll go here. Oops, actually we're going to go here. We'll click on Refresh, and that went away. And so here I am, I'm using essentially no theme. It's literally stripped down to nothing. And I've got my header right here. I've got the full page template right here. So the question really is, Do you need a theme? And the answer to that question is maybe you don't. I know you might be surprised hearing that from me, but maybe you don't need a theme. However, there are some things to consider if in that question, if you need a theme or not. So let's go ahead and take a look at this. You're gonna want a theme if you want to have global styles, global color styles, global fonts, also styling of certain traditional theme parts like your comments section. Those are styles that should come from a theme. Now with Elementor, it allows you to set and define a couple of fonts. It's about 4 fonts and about 4 colors, and that's pretty much it. Everything else, you're gonna have to manually choose the font and manually choose the color, which isn't so bad, except if you later on want to change a font or change a color, then you're gonna have to go back to every single spot and make that change. It can be a little on the tedious side. Next, and this I think is the real big thing for me, is plugin integrations. And so this would be, for example, with the let's just take all of the themes, GeneratePress, Ocean WP, and Astra, all 3 of those, WooCommerce integration. If you want WooCommerce integration and some of those special features when you're interacting with WooCommerce and the shop page and on the product page and on the shopping carts, you're not going to get that out of this concept of having no theme or a bare bones theme and just using the page builder. You're just not going to get those. A perfect example is I know Ocean WP and Astra has it, where you're looking at the shop page and you can hover over a product image and there's a button that you can click and the product pops up in a pop-up, you can add it to cart and check out. You don't get those if you're going for a no theme. Another example with the Astra theme is they have Lifter LMS integration. So out of the box, you plug Lifter LMS in and it looks beautiful. You're not going to get that out of having this no theme theme. Same goes for LearnDash. They're working on LearnDash integration. They're also working on an events calendar integration. So integration meaning you just plug the plugin in and it's going to look perfect out of the box. That's what I mean by integration. So it's not to say that you can't use WooCommerce, Lifter LMS, LearnDash, events calendars. You can't use that with this no theme concept here, but it's going to require a whole bunch of heavy lifting to style it if you choose to go the no theme route. But to get a better look at this, let's go ahead and look at one of the feature lists of one of these themes that I'm talking about. Let's go ahead and take a look right here at Astra. I'm on their website, and when I scroll down on the particular page that I'm on, it lists out the features. So let's actually just look at this and try to answer the question, are you gonna get this? Or do you actually need this? That's a question that only you can ask. Are you gonna get this or do you need this for your WordPress theme? Okay, transparent header. As of today, Elementor Pro version 2 is not getting you transparent headers, but I assume that they're gonna add that feature at some point, probably sooner than later. Sticky header, it doesn't have that either, but I'm sure they'll add that sooner or later. Page headers, kind of, you get that. More color controls. Now, with one of these themes, you're gonna get color controls for a lot of the different parts of a website that you want a color control on. With Elementor, you're gonna get control over 4 different areas that you can set globally. Better topography. This is another thing where you're gonna get more topography options in a theme than if you just used pure Elementor. You get 4 different fonts that you can set to be global. Custom layouts, footer widgets, that's already in Elementor Pro 2. Scroll to top link, I'm not such a fan of scroll to top link. That's the little link that'll be in the bottom right of your website and someone can click it and it will scroll them right up to the top of the website. I'm not really a fan of that because I find that there's other things I'd rather have there, like a live chat bubble or something along those lines. But you can actually do that with a third-party plugin. Header sections, white label, blog layouts, you're getting in Elementor 2, site layouts, WooCommerce integration, you're not getting that out of Elementor. Spacing control, yes, you actually have full spacing control out of Elementor. More header designs, mega menu, there isn't a mega menu that's out for Elementor. I think there might be some third-party plugins you can add to get a mega menu inside there. I think really what's gonna happen is it's gonna boil down to a theme offering you ready-to-go sites or starter sites, I think that's going to be a big reason to buy a theme moving forward. And then I think it's really going to boil down to plugin integrations. So if you are wanting to have a basic kind of what they call a brochure website, that right there, you might not need a paid theme. You might just want to go with this basic Elementor theme. I don't know if they're going to release it or develop it further. Maybe they're just using it for testing, but it's certainly an interesting concept. Then you might want to consider something like that. If you don't need any integrations, all you need is a header, a footer, and whatever is sandwiched in between, you might not need it. But those are my opinions. I want to know what you think. And the best place for you to share your opinion on this concept is in the comment section down below. Let me know what you think about themes and what is going to be a purchase decision or a decision to use one theme over this potentially new concept of using no theme. I'd love to hear about it from you in the comment section down below. Hey, if you enjoyed this video, go ahead and give it a thumbs up and remember, subscribe. And I appreciate you taking the time to watch this video, and I look forward to seeing you in the next one.